In this video, I'm going to show you the best way to organize all of your digital business files. Hey everyone, Megan here from MeganMins.com, where I help busy entrepreneurs like you save time while running their business. As business owners, it can be very easy to let all of your digital and electronic files pile up. But by taking a few minutes to set up a filing structure that works for you, it will not only be easy to maintain, but you'll know where to find everything the moment you need it. So let's get started. I use Google Drive to store and organize all of my files. And if you haven't signed up for Google Drive yet, I do have a link below this video that you can go ahead and sign up right now. You get 15 gigabytes for free to start off if you sign up for the Google Apps for Work, which is now called G Suite. You can actually get unlimited storage, which is what I have, and you can see I definitely need it. In my Google Drive, I have five folders. Archived, which is where I store outdated files and folders that are no longer relevant. Education, which is where I save ebooks, PDFs, and any resources that I am using to continue to learn and educate myself. Megan Mins, this is my home base for my business files, so I'll dig a little bit more into this in a minute. Personal, which is where I store all of my personal files. And website in a box. Now, website in a box has its own folder because it is a separate co-created product between Mariah Kaz and I. So that's why it's not underneath my business folder. Since we're going to be talking about how to organize your business files, I'm gonna focus on this business folder. So if we open it up, you can see that I have six folders within here. And I have found that this arrangement works really well. I actually got the foundation for this structure from a blog post from a friend of mine named Maya Elias. So I'll link to her original blog post beneath this video so you can check it out. And you'll also see how I have customized it and modified it to work for me. So the first folder is called Brand Elements. Then we have Content and Products, Finances and Accounting, Internal Communication, Legal Documents, and Miscellaneous. So if you open up the Brand Elements folder, you'll see that I have all the different types of brand elements you might need, whether that's B-roll, so background video, background footage for videos, my bio, my business cards, fonts, headshots, intro videos, music, styled stock photos, photos for my website, and all that good stuff. This is really helpful because I'm not only keeping files organized, but when I added a VA and a video editor to my team, it was so easy to share the exact brand elements that they needed to use to help me run my business. Plus, it's so nice to always know where these things are. The Content and Products folder is definitely the biggest folder, and this is every type of content or product that might exist in my business. So that can go from affiliate promotions to challenges or courses, ebooks, free downloads I offer, my newsletter, any random tech tutorials, webinars, and of course my YouTube videos. So whatever kind of content and products that you're creating in your business, it would be great to go ahead and create a folder for each of them. And some of these folders, just as a little tip, are actually empty, but they're great reminders for me that I want to do these things. So I don't have an ebook or an email course yet, but I want to. So just by having the folder there, it really motivates me and reminds me that this is something I do want to create for my business. Next is the finances and accounting folder. I am actually not going to go into that in detail, but you can see at a high level that I have a place for a budget, invoices, goals, income trackers, and receipts. So whatever kind of financial and accounting documentation you need for your business, go ahead and give it its own folder. Again, this is also great to keep separate because when you do start to grow a team, there's gonna be certain folders you wanna share with your team and other folders that you won't. So it kind of helps keep the separation there. Internal communication, for me, this means anything that's just about the actual team and things that the team needs, but don't really see the light of day outside of our business. So maybe this is some strategy, customer service templates, goals and planning, meeting notes, interviews. Operations is a general folder that I share with my virtual assistant so we can share processes and timesheets. and all that good stuff. So internal communication will continue to grow as I expand my team and get better about documenting things that we do as a team. Now, legal documents. This is where I store all of my templates, so any legal templates I have, as well as signed contracts, any licenses, and website policies. So again, highly recommend that you have a legal documents folder. It just really helps things stay where they need to be, and you know where to find the important stuff when you need it. Now, the miscellaneous folder is kind of a catch-all. So when I was rebranding, I had a folder for it in here where I kept all of that, the questionnaire, inspiration. I could actually probably go ahead and archive this now that I have rebranded, but for now it's still sitting in miscellaneous. Research and inspiration is a big catch-all folder for all those screen grabs that I capture when I see an inspiring sales page or a great thank you page, or I love how someone did a welcome sequence. I'll capture all of that inspiration and store it all here so I can always go back and see it and I don't have to dig around in my computer. Then I recently added this catch-all folder called To File. This is not an ideal system, but if you want to just be realistic, sometimes you need to go ahead and upload things to Google Drive so they're off your computer, but maybe you don't have time to necessarily organize them. So I created this little catch-all To File folder that is just a temporary placeholder when I want to go ahead and back up something, but I don't have time to actually go ahead and organize it. So hopefully this will be something I eliminate, but for now it's there and it does work to ensure that everything is still backed up. So that is the inside of my business folder. I have found this structure to be really successful. I have used it on a team of one up to a team of six or more, and it's very, very effective, easy to use, easy to stay organized, and something that I hope you will implement in your business. Now you know how to organize your files, but I understand if you didn't have a few minutes to work through this alongside me. So that's why I created a free file organizing cheat sheet for you to reference when you do have a few minutes to tackle this project. You can download this free cheat sheet right now by clicking the link in the corner of this video or below this video. After you finish organizing your files, I want you to come back and leave a comment below this video and let me know. If you thought this video was helpful, please subscribe, share it with your friends, and hit the like button below so I know to make more videos like this. I'll see you in the next one. It's so easy to let all of our files pile up and get organized. Unorganized. Disorganized? Unorganized? It's so easy to let all of our digital or electronic. It's so easy to let all of our, one of those should be okay.